Hello friends, this is the second video in the video series of biochemistry, and in this video we are going to talk about hydrogen ions. So let me first tell you why is it important to study about hydrogen ions. So we know that 70% of our body weight is water, okay, and this water, it autoionizes, okay. So this H2O, it autoionizes to form hydrogen ions and hydroxide ions. And if you see, depending on the concentration of hydrogen ions, many of the biomolecules, they behave differently. For example, amino acids, okay. So if in the aqueous solution the concentration of hydrogen ion is very high, amino acids are going to have a different structure. And in the same way, if the hydrogen ion concentration in the environment is very low, amino acids are going to have a different structure, okay. And that is why we say that the protein structures, they change depending on the hydrogen ion concentration of the environment, okay. Now let us first talk about water. So this H2O, it dissociates to form H positive and OH negative, okay. Now let us see how much H positive is there, how much OH negative is there under standard conditions, okay. So at room temperature, that is 25 degrees Celsius, at 25 degrees Celsius the concentration of hydrogen ions is 1 into 10 raised to power minus 7 moles per liter, okay. So this is molarity. Molarity is moles per liter. So the hydrogen ion concentration is 10 raised to power minus 7 moles per liter. The OH ion concentration is also 10 raised to power minus 7 moles per liter. Why are both of them equal? Because each molecule of H2O is going to give one hydrogen ion and one hydroxide ion. Okay. Each molecule of H2O is going to give us one hydrogen ion and one hydroxide ion. And therefore, both of these are equal. Now, there is a constant known as ionization constant of water. Okay, this is very important. There is a constant which is denoted by Kw, which is ionization constant of water under equilibrium conditions, and it is the multiplication of the concentration of hydrogen ions and the concentration of hydroxide ions. Okay, so if you multiply these two concentrations, we are going to get a constant, and that is known as autoionization constant of water. So it comes out to be, so this is 10 raised to power minus 7, this is also 10 raised to power minus 7, so it comes out to be 10 raised to power minus 14. So this is molarity, this is also molarity, and so the multiplication becomes molarity square, as simple as that. So this autoionization constant, the value of the autoionization constant is 1 into 10 raised to power minus 14 molarity square. Now we have talked about hydrogen ions, but there is a concept of pH. So what is this pH? Now it is difficult to represent the information about hydrogen ions in these terms, 1 into 10 raised to power minus 7, or I'll have to write 0.00000007. So it is difficult to represent and relate different chemical species and the hydrogen ion concentration in them, okay. So to make it really simple to understand the concentration of hydrogen ions, what we do, we take a negative log of the concentration of hydrogen ions, okay. So pH is nothing but negative log of concentration of hydrogen ions. So wherever you see this P, you should, it should strike in your mind that it is negative log of something, okay. So pH is negative log of hydrogen ion concentration, pOH is negative log of hydroxide ion concentration, pKw is negative log of whatever the value of Kw is, okay. So pH here is negative log of the hydrogen ion concentration, that is 1 into 10 raised to power minus 7, and the negative log comes out to be 7. pOH is negative log of 1 into 10 raised to power minus 7, that is the concentration of hydroxide ion, and it again comes out to be 7. Now what is pKw? So pKw is negative log of Kw. pKw here is negative log of Kw, which comes out to be 14, okay. So whenever we are taking log, we do not consider the units, okay. So this molarity, whatever the units is, molarity or molarity square, they do not play any role when we are taking log, okay. So here also the pH comes out to be just 7, there is no unit of it. pOH again 7, and pKw is 14, okay. Now as we see that the concentration, the Kw is the value of concentration of H multiplied by concentration of OH, and we can derive another formula by this. We can derive another formula by this equation, that is, if you take negative log on both the sides, you are going to get negative log of Kw, which is equals to negative log of H positive plus negative log of OH negative. Okay, so whenever you are taking log, so log A into B is equals to log A plus B, log A plus log B. So this is the formula for log A into B. So here also, if you take negative log on the right hand side, it is going to be negative log of H positive multiplied by OH negative, which will come out to be negative log of H positive plus negative log of OH negative. Okay, so now if what is this negative log? You know what is this negative log? This is P. So we can replace it by PKW is equals to again negative log PH positive, again negative log plus P OH. So this is important for some questions where you have been given pH and they ask for POH, or where you have been given pH and POH and they ask for PKW value. So whenever you have this pH, you just need to subtract it by 14 and you are going to get POH, as simple as that. So this is one important formula that you need to note down. Apart from this, you also need to know this important term, that is P. P means negative log of something. So if it is pKa, it just means the negative log of the value of Ka. And we are going to discuss how amino acids are affected with because of the pH of the environment solution, pH of the environment of the amino acid. So suppose you mix some amino acid in an aqueous solution whose pH is very low. So how is the structure of amino acid going to change? So we are going to discuss all of that. Now, right now, let us discuss what happens if we try to disturb the equilibrium. I told you that this H2O is getting converted to H positive and OH negative, and this entire reaction is in equilibrium, therefore we get this constant, that is ionization constant. Okay, this entire reaction is in equilibrium. What does equilibrium mean? That the rate of forward reaction is equal to the rate of reverse reaction, that is equilibrium. Now let us see what happens if we try to disturb the equilibrium. And how are we going to disturb the equilibrium? We are going to add some more hydrogen ions from outside inside that water. Okay, so the compounds which increase the concentration of hydrogen ions are known as acids. Okay, so if you add something in water and it increases the concentration of hydrogen ion, that compound is acid. Okay, so something that increases the concentration of hydrogen ion is an acid, and something which decreases the concentration of hydrogen ion is a base. And you can understand it by another means, that is, if something decreases the concentration of OH ions, that is acid, and something which increases the concentration of OH ion, that is base. And we are going to see how the effect in concentration of H positive causes an effect in the concentration of OH negative. So suppose there is water and you add some acid into it. Okay, so what you do, you add a few H positive ions. So what is acid? Acid is essentially something that causes a rise in the H positive ions. Okay, so what is going to happen? Some of these H positive ions, suppose these two H positive ions, they are going to bind with OH and form H2O. Okay, and these other H positive ions, they are going to increase the concentration of H positive ions already present in the water. Okay, so these H positive ions are going to bind with OH negative ions to form water, and these H positive ions are going to increase the concentration of H positive ions. So you understand that once you add acid in water, the concentration of H positive is going to rise, but at the same time the concentration of OH negative is going to decrease, because some of that OH negative is now forming water combining with H positive. In the same way for bases, if you add few OH negative ions inside water, so something that adds few OH negative ions inside water is a base. Okay, so now if you add few OH negative ions, what is going to happen? Some of these OH negative ions are going to bind with water and they are going to form H2O, and these other OH negative ions are going to remain as OH negative and going to increase the concentration of OH negative ions inside the water. Okay, so what is actually happening? As soon as you add a base inside the water, as soon as you add base inside water, the concentration of OH negative ions increases. At the same time, some of these OH negative ions, they bind with H positive and form water, hence causing a decrease in the H positive ion concentration. So if you add an acid, the H positive ion concentration rises, OH negative ion concentration decreases, and the opposite happens with base. That is, when you add a base, the concentration of OH negative increases and the concentration of H positive decreases. Now the important point here is that increase and decrease only happens until we reach again that equilibrium constant. Okay, so until we reach the equilibrium constant, these changes are going to happen. Okay, so what I'm trying to say here is that the multiplication of the concentrations should give us 10 raised to power minus 14. That is our motive, that is the motive of the equilibrium. Okay, so if you add an acid, the concentration of H positive is going to rise, but at the same time the concentration of OH negative is going to decrease, so as to maintain this value. Okay, if you add a base, the concentration of OH negative is going to rise, but at the same time H positive is going to decrease, so as to maintain this value. So whatever you add inside water, at equilibrium the concentration, the product of concentration of H positive and OH negative is going to remain the same, it is not going to change. Okay, so if you add an acid inside water or if you add a base inside water, under equilibrium conditions the multiplication of H positive ions and OH negative ions is going to remain 10 raised to power minus 14 molarity square. Okay, this is very important. This is very important for you to understand that under equilibrium conditions this autoionization constant is maintained. It is a constant. Okay, it is a constant. It is going to remain constant whatever you add in water. Okay, so that is all about this. In the next video we are going to start with proteins and amino acids, and those are going to be very interesting lectures. So we are going to discuss how amino acids change their shape, structure, how proteins they change their shape and structure, what are the different exceptions in amino acids and different properties of the amino acids. We are going to discuss all of that. So stay tuned. Thank you.